Here we can see the Zener diode IV curve. Basically, a Zener diode has three operational regions. We can start with forward bias, region number 1 here in this graph. A forward bias condition is established by applying a positive potential to the anode and a negative potential to the cathode. Depending on the type of PN junction, the potential difference required to forward bias the Zener diode is around 0.7 volt for silicon PN type and is around 0.2 volt for germanium type PN junction. In this case, we consider the silicon type. When a Zener diode being forward biased, then it will operate as an ordinary diode. So it allows current flow in one direction and prevents current flow in opposite direction. The second region is when a Zener diode is reverse biased, but before it gets to its breakdown point, so-called breakdown or Zener voltage. In this case, a positive potential is applied to the cathode terminal and a negative potential to its anode terminal. In this region, the Zener diode will be off and there will be a very small leakage current flowing from cathode to anode. In most electronic applications, we neglect this small reverse leakage current. The third region is Zener or breakdown. In this region, the Zener diode is still reverse biased, but by increasing the reverse potential, it reaches a point where the Zener diode starts conducting rapidly. As you can see, the breakdown region in the IV curve here, when the reverse voltage is applied to the Zener diode, then a voltage remains constant even for a wide range of current flowing through it. This is the region a Zener diode expected to be in and operates in most electronic circuits. Now back to analyzing this op-amp limiter circuit. Let's assume both diodes D1 and D2 are off and we are interested to know what will be the output VO in relation to input signal. As you can see here, when we remove the D1 and D2 diodes, the circuit becomes an inverting op-amp amplifier with following input-output relationship. And by plugging the R1 and R2, we will have now, when VI is at its maximum possible, which is positive 0.5 volt, then VO will be at its minimum. This is because of the inverting op-amp negative gain. And also when VI is at its minimum possible, which is negative 0.5 volt, then VO will be at its maximum. Let's draw the output signal here. Okay, here is the output waveform. As previously mentioned, this is the output voltage signal without considering the diode's effects. Now let's find the conditions when diode D2 enters to the breakdown region. When VO is equal to D2 breakdown voltage plus diode D1 forward bias voltage, then both diodes will turn on. Let's write the expression here. Here is the simplified circuit for this condition. So what does this mean? Imagine output VO is negative 8.9 volt. Then D2 gets reverse bias because its anode terminal is connected to the op amp output terminal and its cathode is connected to D1, which is now forward biased and has a negative 0.7 volt at its cathode terminal. As you may notice, the diode D1 will act as an irregular diode and its anode terminal gets forward bias from the op-amp inverting terminal, which is a virtual ground. Therefore, as long as D2 stays in the breakdown region, it will limit the output voltage at negative 8.9 volt. So we will have now we know that the output voltage will not go under negative 8.9 volt, but how high the output voltage can rise. Before we continue, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Your support will help this channel to grow and encourage me to create more content. Thank you, and now back to the video. With the same approach, when output voltage VO gets to the positive 8.9 volt, then diode D2 gets forward biased from output terminal of the op-amp, and it will act as a regular diode. This will put D1 in reverse bias, knowing the anode of D1 is connected to the inverting terminal of the op-amp, which is virtually grounded. Let's write the output expression for this condition. Here is the simplified circuit for this condition. Therefore, as long as D1 stays in the breakdown region, it will limit the output voltage at positive 8.9 volt. So we will have we can also calculate at what input levels the output voltage will reach to negative 8.9 and positive 8.9 volts. Here's how we can determine. When VO is equal 8.9. The same way when VO is equal to minus 8.9, and then we will have VI at positive 0.445. In summary, the circuit output to input voltage relationship will be when VI is greater or equal to 0.445 volt, then VO is minus 8.9 volts. When VI is smaller than minus 0.445 volt, then VO is positive 8.9 volt. When VI is between minus 0.445 volt and positive 0.445 volt, then VO is the slope of this line is actually the gain of this amplifier minus 20, which is R2 to R1. If you enjoyed watching this video and found this channel helpful, please like, subscribe, and share your thoughts under the comments.